We're live.
What?
I told you I was going live. That whole thing was on there.
Diamond ring finger at a Baltimore hotel society gathering, and the cops was called in and his weapon took from him as they rode him in custody down to the station and booked William Zanzinger for first degree murder. But you philosophize disgrace and criticize all fears. Take the rag away from your face. Now ain't the time for your tears. William Zanzinger, who at 24 years owns a tobacco farm, 600 acres, with rich, wealthy parents who provide and protect him, and high office relations in the politics of Maryland, reacted to his deed with a shrug of his shoulders, in swear words and sneering, and his tongue it was snarling. In a matter of minutes, on bail was out walking. But you philosophize disgrace and criticize our fears. Take the rag away from your face. Now ain't the time for your tears. Hattie Carroll was a maid in the kitchen. She was 51 years old and gave birth to 10 children, who carried the dishes and took out the garbage, and never sat once at the head of the table, and didn't even talk to the people at the table. Just cleaned up all the food at the table and emptied the ashtrays on a whole other level. Got killed by a blow, laid slate by a cane. that sailed through the air and came down through the room. Doomed and determined to destroy all the gentle, and she never done nothing to Williams and Singer. And you who philosophize disgrace and criticize all fears, take the rag away from your face. Now ain't the time for your tears. In the courtroom of honor, the judge pounded his gavel to show that all's equal and that the courts are on the level, and that the strings in the books ain't pulled and persuaded, and that even the nobles get properly handled. Once that the cops have chased after and caught them, and that the ladder of law has no top and no bottom. Stared at the person who killed for no reason. He just happened to be feeling that way without warning. And he spoke through his cloak, most deep and distinguished, and handed out strongly for penalty and repentance. William Zansinger with a 6-month sentence. Ah, but you who philosophize disgrace and criticize all fears, bury the rag deep in your face, for now's the time for your tears.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Shabbat shalom.
I don't really have very many other songs prepared.
Well, it's only 9:08, so that's not good.
It's a problem. Maybe we should look at an item.
Hi, Jean. Or several items. Hi, Jean. Hi, Jean.
Hey.
Hope everybody's doing okay.
Look who's here.
Look who's here. Where is he? Hi, Daisy.
Got a little booty.
Basil and Casey are here.
How old is that fucking song?
Let's see.
50 years old?
Speaking of fucking song, hi, Charles. He's
47 years old.
Wasn't it 1960 something?
That's not.
From 64.
Wow. Stop making out with your Kilcroydon. Yeah, Basil does make everything better.
You missed me making out with my Kilcroydon.
Ew, Jeff, gross. Oh, hi, Sammy.
Hi.
Hi, Spencey.
Hi.
Real names to be proof.
We learned punk rock in Hollywood. Drove up from Pedro. We were fucking corn dogs. We go drinking pogo. Bob Dylan to me. My story could be his songs. I am his soldier child. Our band is scientist rock. But I was E. Bloom, Richard Hell, Joe Strummer, and John Doe. Playing a guitar. History lesson part two by the Minutemen.
Jesus, there's a gigantic fly in here.
There's a fucking fly in here.
I think that fly loves me. It follows me everywhere in the house.
Is that your pet?
Can you blame it?
Aww.
You have a pet. Why don't we have a pet fly?
We do, and it's flying in here right now. I swear, it follows me everywhere.
Casey and I saw a TikTok of somebody who kind of sadistically made a bumblebee into it, his pet.
They put a leash on it.
That's not horrible. Okay.
Ugh. It was fine. They ended up letting. Well, I think they got stung.
Yeah. Good.
I know.
Ugh. Anywho. Hi, everybody. Aww.
I love you.
Love you too.
Aww, I love you too. And I love you too.
Love you guys.
The Dalai Lama's going live right now.
Wait, should we be competing with His Holiness? I don't know if I can compete with that.
Try seeing The Lonesome Death of Hattie, Carroll, Dalai Lama.
Yeah, right. Remember all the words to that
Oh,
one.
Danny. It's Danny just requested Sammy to sing Easy to Be Hard from Hair. I was going to open with Easy to Be Hard tonight. That's funny you should say that, but...
Golden Smog used to
play
that.
Did he notice I'm wearing my Sunday in the Park with George shirt? Even though it's the worst musical ever.
But our jukebox doesn't have the hair version. It has the, who is it? Three Dog Night?
He used to play that in Golden Smog. But...
Well, you should play it
again.
Funny
enough, I was in Golden Smog when we would play that song frequently, and I don't think I ever really learned it.
Who's saying? But that's a fantastic song.
It is. It's got, but it has a lot of chords.
We're not starting a beef with the Dalai Lama.
The Nuge and Dalai Lama are only...
Wait.
Spencer, don't even say their names in the same sentence.
Is this some sort of symbolism to because you're half Jewish?
He's not half Jewish.
Half
Jewish. How dare you?
Well, I mean...
What are you talking about? Oh, he's wearing one Hanukkah sock? Sammy, what? Sammy, no, that is just pure laziness.
In like, June or May.
Is this your socks is together. It laundry day?
Yeah, I need to do some laundry.
I'll bet. Because, like, I think that the Sunday in the Park with
you
George
know you
shirt,
converted to Judaism, right?
I know that. I'm just saying, genetically, whatever, like, you... Whatever.
Yeah, but Sammy, you need to... I mean, it's not like wearing different socks is your thing. If it was, fine. But
no,
this is just laziness.
I didn't have a matching pair.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Do you have any idea how, like,
guys,
my rage
is
rising right now?
We are live.
Because, oh, God, I can't
this
with the socks.
This is exactly why people
I
do that.
I always wear mismatched socks.
But that it's fine if you do because it's your thing, but not if...
I don't know if it's my thing. I think it's just...
You
really
never
hard.
Wear matched socks?
Well, I am right now because I bought a new pack of socks at Walgreens.
Did you, Every time you've been over here, you've been wearing matching socks?
Yeah.
I've never noticed you not wearing matching
Spencer,
socks.
Can you weigh in?
I don't think I've ever seen you wear not matching socks.
Oh.
You're very.
I feel like I will match the color. Oriented.
Do you know one time?
Okay.
Is it your thing though?
I wouldn't call it my thing.
I don't even mind if it's because of
Mom,
weight.
Will you weigh in?
I'm not gonna talk about
one
it.
One time I was getting my picture taken with RZA.
I wonder how many people said that.
It was for
tonight.
Spin magazine. It was like I was wearing Chuck Taylor's and they were untied, and he asked me if that was my thing, and I said it's kind of my thing because I don't feel like tying them, and he said that used to be my thing.
Wow.
So RZA and I have that in common.
Yeah, Bruce, I remember that you always used to do that. Hi, Bruce. Hi, Dad.
It's kind of dangerous, especially on an escalator.
Yeah, that's... Your socks aren't even, like, the same thickness.
They're not.
Yeah, that would drive me out of my mind.
And is... Yeah. This one's inside out, isn't it?
Oh, my God.
Casey's mom weighed in on the truth.
And she said, I never wore matching socks. And she said, they aren't even, like, the same kind of sock. One is thick and one is thin, and it makes me crazy.
Oh, that is...
And now that she has pointed that out, A, I feel like an idiot for not noticing, and B, I'm also... I share her frustration.
Wow, look at... What is this incredible light show that's happening on our TV?
Oh, turn the TV off, Spencer. Okay.
So. Does anyone have any questions?
Does anyone have any questions? Danny interviewed RZA.
Yeah,
he did. Oh, I remember that. Sammy had to educate him. I remember
Why
that
Why didn't
now.
He ask me? Because I was friends with him.
I think that was before... You became best friends with RZA. Everyone has great hair tonight.
JPEG Mafia never calls me back anymore.
Oh, why does he hate you?
I don't know. I don't know what I did.
What was it like meeting Elton John?
He was
charming.
Just deliriously wonderful to be around.
He was
really,
so
really
sweet
and just such a genuine He made me feel like he loved my music and knew who I was. And
then you never heard from him again.
And never heard from him again. But he did introduce me to Leon Russell, which was a really incredible gift.
It was at some award show. What was it? Oh, no, it was Music Cares something?
Yeah, it was when we did a tribute to Neil Young.
Right.
Do that song sometime.
Hundreds of people have been asking what brand your jean jacket is.
My jean jacket?
Yeah. Sammy, read the label. What is it?
I don't know what it is.
Let me see this button.
I think it's Madewell.
Yeah, Madewell.
Madewell. Okay. Whoosh. Lizzo. I wish it was Lizzo. You should do something with Lizzo.
I want to do something with everyone.
Yeah.
Everyone that will have me. Yeah, no, that's not true. There are some real pieces of shit out there I don't want to do stuff with.
That's for sure.
But, were there other questions?
Yes.
Are you tired?
Pretty tired.
Am I keeping you up?
Yeah. No.
I can't imagine Jeff walking into Madewell. Did you, or did you order it online?
I did not walk into Madewell.
I think you got that at a photo shoot, and you kept it.
No, I think that... I actually think that they sent me some stuff, and it was really nice of them. Which is what happens when you're super famous.
Yeah, right.
Tell that to Itamar.
Yeah, well... Okay, let me calm down.
You need more fans. You don't have much... What is it?
Don't have much fans.
Not much fans.
Well, let me calm down. I don't think he says that.
Yes, he does.
Says not many fans. Let's read it.
Let's read it.
Where is it?
I'm really becoming the
Now, I know that they
IT
won't...
IT guy?
They won't be on here tonight to enjoy it because it's Shabbos.
Yeah, this is a good... This is a good night to roast our relatives.
Did you get to meet Paul McCartney at Bonnaroo?
No, they wouldn't even let me back to my own dressing room. Seriously.
Yeah.
They locked it down and I couldn't get back.
I know,
there.
And I can't even play them on the jukebox.
Everybody else, or I think most...
That's it. Not so much fans. Yeah.
Everybody else in the band got to meet Sir Paul.
What?
You've met Paul McCartney, haven't you?
Why didn't you get to then? Why does he hate you?
He was
so
at
much?
An after Grammy party, and I was not going to go to an after Grammy party.
To the person who just asked.
Even to meet Paul McCartney.
Yes, we didn't do watch Drunk History and love it, and we want Jeff to be on it.
I've been lobbying for myself to be on it for some time.
To who?
I know
me?
A lot of no I... to people that have been on it. I have friends that have been on it. Abby's been on it.
Yeah, so what? They're not, like, in charge
Nick's
of it.
Nick's been on it. And hasn't Nick been on it? Nick's been on it.
I don't know. I love Drunk History so much.
Is it on your Facebook
It's on
page?
My Facebook. Yeah.
Hmm.
Probably under, like, mobile uploads or...
Oh, I found it.
You found it?
Yeah.
Okay, give it to Dad to read. Okay, we are going to read again the letter that our cousin Itamar, he was 8 years old at the time... wrote a story about Jeff. There's the fly. Look, you can see it. I've got it on camera.
There he is, on my guitar.
Oh, my God.
He wants to be a star.
And it was...
This is unbelievable.
He had to...
See, that's what happened. I washed my hair, and now I'm drawing fucking flies.
No, that fly's been in here for days. But anyway, Itamar wrote a story about Jeff. There's actually a whole nother one, too. But anyway.
Go ahead and read it.
Jeff
Tweedy should get more money and more fans by Itamar David. Do you know who Jeff Tweedy is? He's one of the best musicians out there. In 2016, Jeff Tweedy got nominated for a Grammy, but he doesn't get paid a lot of money and he doesn't get a lot of fans. I hope this convinces you. Maybe you guys can support him so he can get more money and more fans. One reason is Jeff Tweedy does not even have a very big place. I've been to his house before, and I think he needs more space. That's why he needs more money. Next, why he needs more fans. Fans also give you more money, and he does not have so much fans. Not so much. Okay, let me calm down. Maybe you guys can support so he can get more money and fans. I can't read it quite correctly because I...
There's a lot more exclamation
there's
points.
Exclamation points that I'm not obeying.
Oh, it's so good. Is that the end?
That's the end.
Okay,
now
let me calm down.
That is a 5-paragraph essay.
Yeah.
That is the best essay ever.
Where's the...
Yes, of course Jeff won't be one of the drinkers on Drunk History. He'll be one of the actors. He doesn't drink.
No, I would have my first drinks.
No, you will not.
In 20, like, something years.
Like 28 years or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, something like that.
Well, that's not going to happen.
I think it would make for an incredible performance, though.
Okay.
And it would be so cheap for them because they wouldn't need to buy that much alcohol.
Is this really a great idea?
Banana schnapps is what I would, is what I'm craving right now.
Ew.
Ew.
All right.
I don't crave alcohol ever.
Yeah, you'd be as good as one of the reenactors.
I want... The only thing that's been hard is I stopped drinking way, way before the microbrew, craft brew fucking revolution. All of that stuff looks so delicious because it's packaged in, like, gorgeous cans and bottles and... Right?
Okay. Yeah.
Isn't that shit that looks good?
Fascinating.
Yeah, it's expressive.
So I'm happy that people are starting to have like more micro brewed sodas and seltzers and seltzers. By the way, hard seltzer. Fuck that noise.
This 15 minutes of talking about socks and seltzers and soda.
We didn't prepare in very much material.
Dad's having another Barbagene episode. People
need to hear.
You just fired shots directly at Casey's a pillar of our identity.
Is quite hard seltzer. I think it's appropriating sober culture.
We're fans of the claw.
I drink a lot of regular seltzer too.
I do too.
Can we stop talking about alcohol?
Not talking about seltzer. Spencer and I did a web TV thing or web thing today.
You did? Thanks for telling me. What was it?
Tim Heidecker.
What?
Yeah.
How was that?
It was fun. I mean, he seems like a nice guy, but there were a lot of technical difficulties, so we really didn't hear a lot of what he was saying. He might have said mean things about me, but I didn't hear
him. Was it live?
Yeah.
Why the hell didn't you guys tell me? Jeez.
Sally.
Basil, would you like to sing a song?
Oh, I don't know. It's live, but
I think they had to take off the live stream because it was messing up so much their broadcasting.
Do you
want to
play anything?
Basil,
sing a song.
Is there a request?
Kombucha. My God, the fly just went right in my face.
You probably just scared 1,000 people.
Well, I'm so sorry, Sammy. You try to not scream when a fly almost goes in your eye.
This reminds me of the horse flies.
You're not even supposed to say horse and fly together around me.
You were convinced that they thought you were a...
That wasn't the horse flies. That was the vultures. Or some, like...
No.
When I thought they thought that I was a dead cow floating in the pool.
Because they were circling.
No, that was the birds that were circling.
Condors.
And my bathing suit goes from my neck to my ankles.
Vultures.
And I was, I forgot what kind of birds they were. But, yeah, I was convinced they thought I was a dead cow and they were going to come kill me. Charlesies is laughing about the fly. What the fuck, Charlesies?
I get the fucking fly.
You will not get the fly.
What? Out of here into a forever home.
You will capture it gently and set it free if you do anything. A hawk. It was hawks.
Who's saying that?
Una.
What the fuck does this... No, they were...
Jeff, you weren't even there. It was hawks. God, you're so... annoying. Oh,
does Una think that hawks eat cows?
They do.
I don't think so.
Are you insane right now? They're looking for dead vultures. Animals to
it was
eat.
A vulture.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's okay. That hawks eat like mice and rodents and some other birds and stuff. I don't know what they eat exactly. This is the best show we've ever done.
Yeah, it's so good.
I can't tell you anything you don't already know. Well, I keep on trying when I should just let it go. Well, I keep on singing and your eyes, they just roll. That sounds like someone else's song from a long time ago. You already know the story, and the chords are just the same. You already know I love you, and I sound like what's his name. But you can't stop me, 'cause I already know. I know it sounds like someone else's song from a long time ago. Did he yawn at me during that song?
Yes.
Is he giving me attitude?
He always yawns.
Hi, Bob and Diana. Bob and Diana are here.
Hey.
Let's say hi so they can really hear us. Hi, Bob and Diana! That was hilarious. I hurt my throat.
Good one. I'm wearing a different colored shirt.
Yeah, I know. It's really throwing me off.
Than I normally wear.
You don't look like a mime. Oh, you do look like a mime.
I look like a fruity lemon lime mime.
Oh, good one.
Fruity lemon lime mime.
Hi.
A wordsmith.
Who's a bad boy?
Yes, they're our neighbors. That's why I screamed hi to them. And when we heard that dog barking on the Tweedy show last night, it was their dog.
Was it?
That's what Bob told me. Auction Basil off for charity.
No.
Disgraceful, you would say.
But you could probably auction lunch with Basil.
I think we should do like a mall meet and greet like celebrities do for teenage girls.
Yeah.
Basil. Get Basil on Cameo. He'll do your birthday
Basil
wish.
Basil and Peter Noone.
He'll sing you a birthday song.
I love Peter Noone. Do you know he goes live on Facebook like 1,000 times a day?
Who?
Shut up.
Oh, Peter No One?
Shut your face. Jolly Banker.
He's stupid.
Jeff, how dare you?
People aren't going to get why you're making that joke.
But, you know, he goes on like 1,000 times a day. He's so sweet.
He is sweet. I love him. And I love the messaging made for you.
I know. And then he does all of his merch himself. He's boxing up records all day long. He calls them pizzas because it looks like pizza boxes. And then he goes to the post office and films from there, showing all.
Wait,
adorable.
Does he?
That's what we'll be.
He
doing
boxes up
week.
His own records, like records that he's made recently.
I don't know. Herman's, I just see him doing.
Maybe
this.
People send him the records and he signs them or something.
No, you. I don't know. You can buy them.
I doubt
on
that.
His website. I don't know. He's just so adorable. I can't take it. And he has a dog. That sits on his lap while he does it.
Okay, that's great.
It's like a, oh shoot, what is it? Like a boxer or something?
He's so cute.
Well, I hope you guys enjoy your new dad.
He's married. He's happily married for forever. As am I.
Aww. Who, to who?
Basil. Are you going to play any songs tonight?
I just played a song.
You did? I missed it. Oh, what's the fly's name?
Yes.
Oh, it's a Boston Terrier. We should name our fly.
Wait, do you have enough time?
I don't think so.
Are you guys doing a song?
Oh, I mean, yeah, we could do one together.
Well, if you.
Oh, are you doing one, Spence?
Yeah.
What's happening? I don't. Sammy, sit back. I can't see Spencer.
Do you want me to get up?
No, you don't have to get up.
Maybe Sammy could take Basil to the other chair.
Do you need more room, Spencer, or are you okay?
Andy, I got it.
I want to point out that if that guitar doesn't have dots on the side of the neck, if that's going to be an issue.
It'll be okay.
Because it bothers me sometimes.
Yeah.
If there's a guitar, you want a different guitar?
Spencer's smarter than you.
No, that's true.
Sorry, I have to review one thing.
Who isn't?
Boys.
Yeah, Casey, show your awesome shirt.
Oh, it's so good.
It's the tamale guy.
It's Barrel Maker Press in Chicago.
Is that a benefit shirt for him?
Yeah, for Claudio.
Oh, my God. How do you get one?
Barrel Maker Press, love their website.
Oh, I want to get one. That is so cool.
Isn't that so cute? I love that it says he'll find you.
Oh, I love it.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Can you believe painted
starts to snow. The quiet sun rising shows its face. I'll never know. These things pass me by. They pull me right back.
Good, Spencer. Wow, wow, he really needed those dots.
That guitar sounds great with your style.
Thanks.
Spencer, we lost connection 2 times during your song.
I didn't see it. It didn't happen on my
I thought
end.
That's when you looked at me.
No, I looked at you because someone said Basil's running away from home.
Oh, no. It said pause due to connection, and it went from Wi-Fi to 5 whatever.
That's weird. That song is, the working title of that song is Thick Lizzy.
Thick Lizzy?
Yeah.
Is that a new song?
So good, honey.
It's not a new song.
No, I played it at the show.
Spencer, people want to know why you have to make your song so hard. And also
hard?
For them to play. And also, where can they find your music? SpencerTweedy.com?
Yeah, or just SpencerTweedy.bandcamp.com. That song isn't out yet.
Yes, Una. It skipped twice for Una. I lost connection twice.
Basil.
Spencer, I'm furious.
What?
Our Wi-Fi.
Basil.
Oh, my God. Oh. Can't Basil. Go back to that time.
Well, why did it do that?
I don't know. Sometimes it happens.
What? Sounds like Cat Stevens.
Oh, that's a compliment.
Peter Noone song, please. Yes.
Ooh.
What? Peter Noone?
Well, I don't know. I've never played it before. I want to... I've never...
You can do it.
Well, what was it?
No Milk Today.
No Milk.
Why do you want to play that one?
Do you want to sing
with
me, Sammy?
My love has gone away.
How do you even know that song?
You ask me that every time I sing it. It's funny.
I've never heard you sing it in my life.
I know that song well.
Oh.
No Milk. No Milk Today. My love has gone away. The battery's too low. You sing it, Sammy. But I gotta see the chords.
No milk today, my love has gone away. The bottle stands forlorn, a symbol of the dawn. No milk today, it seems a common sight. But people passing by don't know the reason why. How could they know just what this message means? The end of all my hopes, the end of all my dreams. How could they know the palace there had been? So the company was gay. It turned night into day. How can they know just what this message?
It's not right.
What?
No, that was
that's a different song.
Well, that's weird.
But all that's left is a place stuck in the
oh.
Back of town comes a shrine, and I think I'll be home.
to do an All Herman's Hermits and Carole King and Cat Stevens and Hair the Musical Night.
Dina, So Far Away.
No. By whom?
Carole King.
Oh, no, I don't know.
Spencer, your hair looks so... yeah.
Thank you.
Sorry to abort the song.
Oh, no. I didn't
abort.
Scrubbed the mission.
What's going on over here?
He's getting some love. Don't look at us.
I love Carole King.
You
want to
sing one?
Sure. I don't know what, because I don't know if you know how to play, or do you want to play one of our songs?
Let the sun shine.
You want to play Tell Me Why?
Sure, yeah.
What is this?
We're going to play Tell Me Why by Neil Young.
You cool with it?
Oh. Yeah, absolutely.
Dad just wants to make out with Casey. He doesn't give a shit.
Ew.
I gotta go home. My mom called.
I meant Basil. Oh, my God.
God.
Oh, my God. I'm so sorry.
I've almost called Basil Casey before, too.
I know. I do it all the time.
We're one. It's fine.
It's like, you know, me calling you Spencer and Spencer Sammy.
You up for it?
I did. Yeah. I did ask Spencer and Sammy. I tried to get Spencer and Sammy to sing Afternoon Delight.
Oh, my God. Thinking of you's working up an appetite.
Do I need to capo it?
No, I don't think we did when we played before. It's just go straight into it, right?
Good job, guys.
Whew. Sorry.
It's a heist. I am embarrassed.
Oh, don't be embarrassed.
Don't be embarrassed.
Beautiful song.
I love that song.
You should probably take this away.
Why? I've got this. Can you play Basil?
Oh.
Basil. Basil was whispering in my ear earlier. Aren't you, Basil?
Okay.
I've got him facing you now.
Holy crunk nugget, it's 9:47.
So cute.
I'll play a song.
Do you know how?
I'm going to try.
Hand off the bass.
Hand off the bass.
Bass off.
Gel Croydon. I'll just take this off of you while you reposition yourself.
Yeah.
I'm so nice to you. Oh my god. Oof.
But you were not home. So I talked with some old friends for a while before I wandered off alone. It's so hard for me now, but I'll make it somehow. Though I know I won't ever be the same. Won't you ever change your ways? It's so hard to make love fade when you're on the losing. I miss you more than ever since you're gone. I can hardly maintain. Things are different around here every night. My tears fall down like rain. So hard for me now, but I'll make it somehow. Though I know I won't ever be the same. Won't you ever change your ways? It's so hard to make love pay when you're on. They say everything can be replaced. They say every distance is not near. So I remember every face of every man who put me here. I see my light come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, I shall be released. They say every man needs protection. They say every man must fall. So I swear I see my reflection somewhere inside these walls. I see my light come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, I shall be released. Yonder standing me in this lonely crowd, a man who says he's not to blame. All day long I hear him hollering so loud, just crying out he's not to blame. I see my life come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, I shall be released.
So pretty, you guys. And so touching and moving. What are you doing?
Popping your toes, Knuckles.
Right now? Ow.
Why not?
Because we're on an international television program? Ow!
For the protesters.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh boy. Hey, Liam.
Love you guys. Thank you so much
for
being our clients.
How come Liam didn't quarantine with us?
That's a good question. Yeah. He has a girlfriend or something.
Yeah, but he's our son.
He lives in a different city. Some of those things might have had a contributed to the decision where he's going to quarantine.
That's a bunch of too.
Hey, where was Austin?
Where was Austin?
He said he thought it was Saturday.
Oh yeah, I saw that. Austin. Agreed,
gotta
Danny.
Keep track of the days of the week.
Oh boy.
Oh yeah, Spencer's got the blues, everybody.
Scaring me.
I think that's where our foray into the blues should
At least end. He didn't start singing about balls and stuff.
Which is...
Like he normally does.
You should explain that that's...
Especially...
Or...
After that...
Chicken noodle soup. Can't even do it. First chicken fucking... For chicken fucking... 15 years of your 24 on this fucking planet, you saying chicken noodle soup
chicken noodle like soup? Every... Chicken noodle soup.
It's true. And how ironic.
Chicken noodle soup. Chicken
noodle. Why did Austin just say he needs undies?
Wait, what?
Because he shat himself because the blues was so strong.
Is it...
Not to undermine the sincerity of our previous numbers. Sorry, I don't know. What were you going to say?
Nothing. Old Kale Chip Johnson.
That is my name. Don't worry it out. I'm actually not Killchip. I'm Wi-Fi Willie.
If you're Wi-Fi Willie, why did I lose connection tonight twice?
Because
you need to get your Willie more Wi-Fi. Because
you got to pay your dues. No. Dude, so you got to pay your dues so that, you know.
Oh my God, I have the warning. Go. Bye, you guys. We'll see you all Monday. Say bye, Casey.
I guess we'd wish for
Say bye, Basil.
Incarnation dream. Incarnation. Wouldn't it be a sensation to come back to like a reincarnation to have a dream? Need for the flower. What will we do? I guess we wait for the power of me. Incarnation dream. Incarnation. Wouldn't it be a sensation to come back to like a reincarnation? I love you. Will. Yeah, girl, I'm a boy, but suppose you was a rose and I was a whippoorwill.
Say bye, Jeff.
Goodbye, Jeff.
You guys take care. We'll see you Monday.
Bye.
Bye.